Yes, in this lecture we will try to understand system.out.println. What is this system.println? It is available in Java programming language. We will try to understand this system.out.println in detailed manner. Java system.out.println is used to print. What is the use of this system.out.println? It is used to print. It is used to print an argument. Which one will it print? It will print an argument. An argument that is passed to it. The statement can be broken into three parts, which can be understood separately. What is my first part in the system.out.println? This is my first part. As we were saying that there are three parts. My first part is system. What is this system? I can say system is, first point about system is, it is predefined. It is predefined class. It is predefined class. What is the purpose of this class? It is predefined class that provides access. That provides access to the system. Access to the system. As we were discussing that, all predefined classes starts with some capital letter. This system, it is which type of class? This system is final class. You must remember this one. This class is final class. Yes, what is final class? I will discuss about in detailed manner about final classes after few lectures. Time being, just understand system is final class which is defined. This final class is defined in particular package. What is that package? That package name is java java dot lang lang. This is package. You may ask me what is package. I will discuss about what is packages in future classes. Time being, just understand system is a predefined class which is defined in java dot lang package. There is another part. What is second part? The second part is, it is out. What is this out? It is instance. It is instance. It is instance of, it's instance of, it's an instance of print stream type. Print stream type. Instance means I can say it is just like an object. We will discuss what is instance, what is print stream type. Just time being, understand this out is an instance of which type? I can say it is an instance of print stream type. I can say this out, even I can say like this, it is the output stream. Out is the output stream. It is related to out. In this print stream means I can call this print stream as output stream. It is an output stream that is connected to the console. We will try to understand. Just time being understand. This out is instance of which type? It is an instance of print stream type. In future classes, I will discuss about this particular print stream. What is print stream? What is instance? Even you can say this out is. It is public. It is public and static member. It is a public static member field of system class. What about this third part? What is this println? What is this println? What is the purpose of this println? What is use? It prints. What will it do? It prints any arguments. It prints any argument. It prints any argument passed to it. It prints any arguments passed to it. I can say it adds this particular println adds. println adds a new line. It adds a new line to the output. To the output. Maybe many terms, maybe some sort, you may have some sort of ambiguity on many terms, but certainly you will get clarity. Wait for a few classes. I can say, for time being, just understand it. If in the case of C language, there is something like printf. What is the use of printf? If you want to print something on screen, if you want to print something on console, if you want to print on something on monitor, this printf is useful in the case of C programming language. In the case of C++, there is an object known as cout object, which is useful for printing something on the screen. In similar manner, in our Java programming language, I have println method, isn't it? This is available in system.out.println. As we were saying, that system is predefined class. Out is an instance of print stream type. println is a method. As I told you, here you are having different terms like final class, something like print stream. All those things I will explain. Maybe it may take few classes. Time being, what I will do, let me explain this concept with simple program. Just see this simple program. Here I have a program. What is this program name? Class space class name is Kukatpalli. As we were saying, that your class name must start with capital letter. Just I am starting Kukatpalli with capital K. It's a convention. It's not mandatory thing. If you want, you can write in even small letter also. It's a convention. If you want, you can follow. Otherwise, you need not follow. It's a good practice to write like this. But as I told you, all predefined classes starts with capital letter. Anyway, here I have one class. I'm defining a class. Class name is Kukatpalli. This one is class beginning. This one is class ending. We know what is public. We know what is static. We know what is void main string args. Yes. System dot. What is this system? It is, as I told you, it is a predefined class that provides access to the system. Out is an instance. println is a method. Now, what we were saying, what is the use of println? It prints any argument. For println, what is the argument here? Srikiran is the argument. What we were saying, println prints any argument passed to it. Which argument am I passing here? Srikiran argument I am passing. To whom am I passing? I am passing to println. In such case, what will it print? As I told you, it prints any argument passed to it. Now, I am passing Srikiran argument. Therefore, it will print Srikiran. It's simple and straightforward. ln. println means, we were saying that, what will it do? It adds a new line. ln means it adds a new line. Adding new line means what? After printing Srikiran on screen, after printing Srikiran, your cursor will move to the next line. That is adding new line. Again, here what am I writing? System.out.println and Preeti. This one is argument for my println method. Therefore, it will print and Preeti. Again, system.out.println welcomes you. There again, welcomes you is an argument. After executing this piece of code, just see output. Here I have Srikiran. I am getting Srikiran. After Srikiran, I am printing end Preeti. I am not getting end Preeti here. Why? Because I am keeping println. ln means it, after printing Srikiran, your cursor will move to the next line. Therefore, end Preeti is coming in next line. And print ln means, as I told you, it adds new line. After printing end, Preeti, your cursor will move to the next line. Therefore, your cursor is moving to the next line. Therefore, these three lines you are getting in output. These three lines in separate line. Otherwise, what happened? Just instead of println, just write system.print means it cannot add new line to the output screen. This is a simple program which demonstrates about our system.out.println. Let me take one more simple program. What is this? I am defining a class. My class name is Tirupati. What is my class name? Whichever name you want, you can write. Just I am writing Tirupati. Class space class name Tirupati. This class begins at open flower bracket and ends here. Till now, I have not defined what is class. I will define. Please wait for a few more classes. We know what is the meaning of public static void main string args. Yes, int num1 equal to 10. What is this? This int is data type. What is this int? Data type. What is this data type? I will explain about these data types in my next lecture. Just try to understand timing. Data type, what is the purpose of data type? Basically, let me explain one simple concept here. Basically, Java is a statistical, statistically typed programming language. It is statistically typed programming language. Java is statistically programmed language. What does it mean? It means, what is the meaning of statistically typed? What does it mean? What is intention of this particular statement? Let me write otherwise. I will repeat. Java is a statistically typed programming language. It means all the variables must be declared. All the variables must be declared before its use. Yes, just try to understand. Here I am writing int num1. Here, just say this statement, int num1 equal to 10. What is this int? This is known as data type. This num1 means what? This is variable name. This 10 means what? It's the value. What am I saying? All the variables must be declared. I am declaring this variable num1. How am I declaring? I am declaring its data type is int. All the variables must be declared before its use. Before using num1. Just see, here I am using num1. Before using this particular variable, I must declare. Declaring means I must specify its data type. Of course, I am keeping 10. Initialization is not mandatory. If you want, you can initialize. Otherwise, you need not initialize. But declaration is mandatory. What is statistically typed language? Statistically typed language is a language in which all the variables must be declared before its use. Here I am using num1 variable. Here I am using num1 variable. Before using this variable, I must tell its data type. I am declaring num1 is an integer type variable in which I am keeping 10. What is variable? Basically, int num1 equal to 10 means internally what happens? A memory location will be created. In that memory location, some number, this 10, if I say int num1 equal to 10, number 10 will get stored. It will have some address. Let me say it is 2021 address. This one is known as variable name. It is variable name. In all programming languages, variable name is same. This is value. This I can say, this one is address of that particular variable. Therefore, which one is variable here? Num1 is variable. How can I define a variable, whether it is C or C++ or Java? Variable is a name. Variable, here num1 is variable. Num1 is a name. Variable is a name given to memory location. Variable is a name given to memory location. Here num1 is a variable, it's a name given to memory location. Anyway, maybe I think I am deviated from my topic. Yes, here I have variable num1 whose initial value is 10, its data type is int. In num2 is another variable, of course, whose data type is int, whose initial value is 20, and sum is another variable whose data type is int. I have three variables, num1, num2 and sum. All these are of data type int. Int means I can store only integer values. Integer values means what? What is the meaning of integer values? Integer value means integer is indicated by z. 0, plus or minus 1, plus or minus 2, plus or minus 3. All these values are known as integer values, isn't it? Anyway, system.out.print. Now just see here. I'm not adding println here. Just see, I'm just saying print, not println. Print means it will not add new line to the output. Just it will, after executing the addition of statement, cursor will not go to the next line. Cursor will be here only. Anyway, we will try to understand. In output screen, what will it print? Otherwise, let me show the output screen. Just see now. What is my program name? My program name is Tirupati. How can I compile? JAVAC space Tirupati.java. How can I interpret? JAVAC space Tirupati. Just see output. The addition of. Still cursor in the same line. Why? Because here we don't have ln. Only I have print. Therefore, next statement is also printing in same line. If I keep println, this 10 and 20 will go to the next line. What is here? System.out.println. Here I am adding next line. What is this num1? Num1 is variable. What is the value of num1? 10. That's why it is printing 10. Println means it will print 10. Just say after this, I am appending. Plus means it is useful for append. In print, which one will append? It end means string. How do you know string? I'm keeping in double quotes. If I keep something in double quotes, that can be treated as a string. I'm appending the string end to num1. What? Just remember here, num1 is not string. Why? Because it is not in double quotes. If I keep something in double quotes, that is string. I'm keeping just num1. Num1 means variable. What is its value? 10. Therefore, I'm getting 10. I'm appending for 10 a message end, just I'm getting end, for which I'm again appending num2. Remember, this num2 is not string. Num2 is a variable. Why? Because it is not in double quotes. Therefore, in the place of num2, this 20 will display, for which I'm appending a string. String means if I keep something in double quotes, that is string. Just see, it is appending is. As I am keeping ln, ln means it will add after printing this message, your cursor will go to the next line. Therefore, system.out.println num1 plus num2. My num1 is 10 plus 20, 30. It is displaying 30 in next line. It is simple and straightforward program. Just go through it so that you can understand. It may not advisable to discuss this one in this stage. Why? Because I have to define many things, but let me try to explain this. If you are not able to follow this, certainly you can understand after few classes. Let me say like this. Just observe this code. It is similar to system dot in the place of s out dot in the place of length. It is system dot out dot println, isn't it? Test is similar to system. Out is similar to s. println is similar to length. Just understand, length is predefined method. It is a predefined method which is available in string class. As name suggests, it's useful for finding length of a string. Anyway, let me say this one. Just read this slide carefully. What is this? Class space class name test. Just see, test is class name. What is this test? My test is class name. What is s? S is a variable. Which type of variable? Static type variable. Is a static variable. It's a static variable. Where it is present? This variable is present in test class. Just say it is present in test class. What is its type? Its type is string. its type of string. What is length? Length is a method. Length is a method. As I told you, it is present in string class. Now, how can I access this one? I am interested in finding length of this particular string. What is the length of this particular string? 1, 2, 3, 4. I want to determine. How can I determine? What is the procedure to determine? Just see. What is the procedure? Class name. Class name dot. This is system dot. So class name dot s. S is static variable. It is just like out. Out is also a static variable. Out dot println. Println means length. As I told you, length is a method which is defined in string class. What is the purpose of this length? It is useful for finding length of the string Java. Anyway, let me explain so in similar manner. Let me explain our system. Class space class name system, isn't it? What is this? Static print stream out. Early, just compare this one, my previous slide. System dot out dot println hello. What is my system? I already discussed. System is present in Java dot lang package. What is package? We will try to understand in future classes. What is out? Out, just see, out is a static variable present in system class. This system S is capital letter, system class. Just see, out is a static variable. It's a static variable of type which? Of type print stream. I already discussed print stream or output stream. What is my println? Println means p is small. It's a method. Built-in methods, predefined methods must always small letters. Println. Println is a method present in print stream class. Let me explain. Otherwise, let me combine these two slides so that we will compare. Just see. Just compare these two things, you can understand. Just see here, test. Here we are saying system, isn't it? In the place of s, I have out, isn't it? Just see, how am I writing? Test dot means class name dot, system dot. Here I am writing s. In the place of s, I have out. In the place of length, I have println, isn't it? What is println? It is a method present in print stream class. What is s? S is what is length? Length is a method present in string class. Try to compare these two slides so that you will get an intuition. You can understand an intuitive meaning of system dot out dot println. Why we are using, just if you observe carefully, this I already defined. Out is an instance of print stream class. It is just like an object. I am accessing this particular object with which class? I am accessing this particular object with system class. Yes, generally this system is final class, isn't it? That's what we were saying. What is final class? Those things I will discuss in my future lectures. Time being, just understand, system is a final class defined in java.lang package. This accessing mechanism is little bit different. I am using class to access this particular system, particular object. I am using class. System is a class. I am using class to access this instance, to access this object, isn't it? How it is? It is. What is this mechanism? What is internally? What happens? We will try to understand in future classes. If you are not able to understand these two slides, just wait for a few more classes so that you can understand. At least try to understand in this lecture. If you are able to follow, what is system? What is out? Time being, just understand, system is a predefined class that provides access to the system. Out is an output stream connected to the console. Println is a method which is used to display a message. If you pass some argument, that println prints any argument, pass it to it. Ln means it adds a new line to the output. We will discuss in detailed manner about these type of classes. This system class has got different features. How this class is different from regular classes in my future lectures, I will discuss this concept. Thank you very much.